All right, I wanted to show you guys something. This is for the MB200-2 Trailmaster. And the reason I'm gonna show this before all the other stuff I'm doing is because I think, you know, you could put this on any, even a stock bike could use this mod. Just because the chain's like so long and the way it loosens up when it suspension's all the way extended and when it tightens up as it goes up into the travel, and even stock I had it where it was hitting the back of the driven pulley, or the driven pulley. So this is going to help with my 60 tooth and the longer shocks, but this is also a sweet chain tensioner that's up out of the way, and I can't take credit for it. Another guy figured this out. I don't know if I looked at it long enough. I might have, probably not. Well, I didn't really look at it. I was just going to buy. I just bought one of these. I was going to use one of these. This is one of those, you know, regular ones, and it's adjustable in and out. Spring tension's adjustable, I guess they said. It's pretty nice, and it would probably work. It would hang down pretty far, and I'm sure I'd bash it on rocks and sticks and stuff. I don't know, that's the first time I ever looked at it, because I just left it in the box. But that would work. But so here's what this guy came up with. So this is it's 5/8 inch outside diameter, 3/8 inch inside diameter, and I think it was like a foot long, and I found it on eBay for like 12 bucks or something. I used this to space it out to measure it. It needs to be about 9 1/4 inches. See, here I am on the back of this swing arm here. This is the swing arm pivot. And it has to be between these two bolts, or these two nuts right here. It has to go between there and the one over there. And I measured it's about 9 1/4 inches. It's just easier to get a really good reading by cutting this down, putting it exactly between there. So 9 1/4 inches. And you get 2 5/8 inch locking collars. You don't have to get them split. These are a little more expensive. I just like them a little bit better. And then, yeah, I already measured it out where it needs to be. And I'm just going to put these washers there just so I can put some grease in there. And this thing is just a chain tensioner that comes in a kit. It has like a spring. I don't know where the heck I put the rest of it. But, you know, you're supposed to just hook it up. I don't know. I'll put a link. There's a bunch of these. And this just happens to be about 5/8 inch. Stick it on there like that. Put your other washer. Now I'm going to, once I get done, I'm going to put some grease in there on the final assembly. Hopefully you can see this. So what happens is you put it right between these bolts. And over here, this one goes through here. I'm not going to put the nut on, but see, goes right on there. But actually 3/8, at least this one, the 3/8 didn't quite fit on there, and it was so tight that it wouldn't even really work. So what I did is I cut this off, you know, measured it real, you know, make sure it wasn't too short, about 9 1/4 inches, cut this off, put on a grinder and sanded it, and then I actually primered it and painted it. I was doing these brake parts anyway, so I just figured, well, I'll just put some primer on here, paint it, and then actually this fits a little bit better too, because it was a little bit more loose than this. But these were a little bit too tight, and it was messing up those threads, and it wasn't working right. So what I did, I mean, I'm sure you could just sit there and file it, or, you know, I tried a 3/8 inch drill, but that didn't work because there's already 3/8 inch, and I didn't have a, you know, however many millimeters that is, I didn't have a drill, a metric drill bit like that. So what I ended up doing, which actually worked amazingly well, I don't know how I got it in there right the first time, but I got this so it was, this is just a rat tail file. And somehow or another, the first time I did it, I got it in there perfect. And I just went like this. Now I painted in there so it was a little bit bigger, but so I'm not gonna do it, but I went, put it in there like that and just spun it around until it was, you know, and kept testing it. And I just, you know, made it a little bit bigger. And that worked fine. If you have one of these, stick in a drill, or if you have a perfect drill bit that makes it just big enough, but you don't want it too loose either. So it's, you know, I guess you could just, you know, file it out by hand or whatever, keep test fitting it. So then what you do, you stick that like that, stick this through, this is really cool. You know, the other chain tensioner, you just put right here and it would hang way down, and it would, you know, it would tighten the chain and everything, but I'm sure it would get knocked off of there. So So this is kind of a pain because you gotta like, and these are 14s. So you have to kind of hold that there. All right, like that. And I would do this to a stock, even if you had stock shocks and stock sprocket, I would still do this because that chain, you know, it's really long and it flops around, and you know, the inside of this, you can see, okay, this one here, this is the one that came with it. And look, it's all dug up. And that's pretty bad too. These are some big chunks out of there. And that was everything stock, and you know, so that chain just flops around even when it's everything stock and it's, you know, had it adjusted pretty good. You don't want to have it too tight when it's down here, because you know, when the suspension goes up, then it gets way too tight and then it wrecks your bearings up here and it wrecks these bearings back here. So that's another reason why you want this, so you can have it be loose even at the top, so it's not, you know, binding up the suspension and causing damage to your bearings. So as you can see, but it lines up right with that. You know, I might have to adjust it a little bit once I get everything on there, but it lines up with that sprocket pretty good. It'll be like right about here, I guess. So it's not hanging way down. Like the other one would be hanging way down here, hanging off of that. This thing would be hanging way down here like this. Of course, it'd be fully extended probably, like that. Hanging way down. Maybe it'd be closer to where, you know, you can't put it past this, I guess. So it'd have to be right about here, right where this thing is, you know, and that's hanging way down further. And this thing's going to be up like this, just tucked out of the way. So that's just so cool. And, you know, it looks almost like it could be a factory part there, especially since it's painted and everything. A little bit of the paint got worn off where I was messing with it, but it's primer underneath, so it won't rust. So, you know, this is all super tight. You know, once I tighten this up, this isn't going anywhere. I mean, it can spin barely. Like it's tight right there and kind of looser. I'll get some grease in there so it just won't wear out. And then, okay, so I'm gonna have to drill a hole right here. Have a spring going from down there to up here, and I'll connect it to this. So it'll be a spring right here. And that thing, that's awesome. Here's the rest of this stuff. It has an adapter so you can, you know, put it onto a smaller axle. And it's, you know, this thing you can use if it's some other application. And it came with this white one, this white roller. But of course, blue bike. So I saw this on eBay for like $8, $6 or whatever. And I'll show you which one that is. I can't remember. It's like 10 millimeters. They sell them in 8 and 10. I think that's the 10 millimeter one. So I got an extra one in case that wears out. But now, especially when you get these bigger shocks, bigger sprocket, longer chain, then you really need a tensioner. I just thought that was really cool. Like, I don't know, if I sat here and looked at this long enough, I don't even know if I would have come up with that. I don't know if I would have or not. Probably not. So that's awesome. I think for, you know, to buy this all separately and with tax and everything, I don't know, I'll add it up. But it wasn't more than 30 bucks, I don't think. Maybe 40, I don't know. But just the fact that it's hung up out of the way here and it's just kind of there, It's just a super cool way to do it. So now I don't have a spring to put on here yet. I'm gonna have to get the right tension spring, the right length, and you know, probably experiment a little bit with that. But that's easy. I'll find something that'll work. So I wanted to do a separate video on that because that's just cool. And I'll see if I like these shocks. And I'm gonna have to take these off and see how, you know, see how tight the chain is. When you know, maybe I'll hang this from the ceiling or something, I don't know. I'm gonna have to do something to figure out, you know, the chain tension when this is compressed. And I can't really compress it because these, you know, I could take one of these off, it's still gonna be hard to, you know, I could do this and do some math, I guess, and you know, the radius. I don't know how I'd figure that out, but what I'm gonna do is just take these shocks off and, you know, put it up to about here and make sure the chain tension is not too tight there. And then, you know, whatever it is down here, this should take up the slack. So it shouldn't destroy my bearings up there, shouldn't destroy the bearings down here, and it should let the swing arm travel without any binding. That's the whole point of all this. So All right, hopefully my I'll get this all done and be riding this thing soon. See you in the next one. Later.